Okay, let me ask you a question. Well, they freak you out right away and they'll tell you four of your coronary arteries are 98% occluded. We have to, and you have the most mild angina, or maybe you don't have any angina, right? And we got to do it today. The reason they got their hurry on it is because they're afraid you're going to change your mind. This is marketing and salesmanship, okay? So whatever. So then they go and do that whole procedure, get you on the five mandatory heart drugs, right? According to their own statistics, organized medicine's own statistics, cardiology, what is the reocclusion rate for the coronary arteries after bypass surgery? It is 80% reocclusion rate after, a two-year period. And why is that? I mean, it only makes sense. If your coronary arteries were 98% occluded with plaque, that means there's plaque in all your arteries in your entire systemic circulation, right? Nature abhors a vacuum, right? As soon as you clear out the coronary arteries, it's just going to reposition that plaque from the whole rest of the arterial system. Why don't people think of obvious common sense stuff? That's why we need this oral chelation supplement. It's really simple. I have this chapter, it's called To the Heart Patient. John, you got to read this chapter. It's not very long, it's like 30 pages long or something, but I did a whole study of, you know, the classic heart patient takes five medications. They take the Lipitor, the cholesterol, they take the hydrochlorothiazide, the water pill, and then they take the angiotensin inhibitor, the beta blocker, and the calcium channel blocker. I go through each one of those drugs. Who makes it? What are its physiological actions, and why it ensures that the person who is on that for his lifetime will die of heart disease. In this chapter, To the Heart Patient, we explain how the real authorities, the legitimate medical doctors, tell us you can go cold turkey on any statin drug now with no side effects. You're going to feel better right away. Same with hydrochlorothiazide, no water pills, diuretics now. No problems. The other three are going to take a stair-stepping, but you can do it all in a month. And that's what the medical people say. So, and then once you do that and you start on the digestizyme and the oral chelation, you're actually clearing their arteries. Then for the first time in their life, their lifestyle normalizes, their blood pressure normalizes. You know how childhood allergy is an epidemic in this country? Childhood allergy, it's partly because of the vaccines. The other part of it is because of milk. You get a child off all dairy, milk, cheese, butter, ice cream, yogurt for 60 days if it's pasteurized. Now the calcium thing, children are getting no calcium from pasteurized dairy. You know why? Because the definition of pasteurization is that it is heated until all enzymes are denatured. There is an enzyme in milk, phosphatase, which is necessary for the body to absorb calcium. By definition, this enzyme must be denatured. There is none. So the child is not getting very much calcium. Calcium is the only mineral in which there is really not a deficiency. Calcium is in virtually all vegetables and fruits. It's in almost all foods. We don't have a deficiency of the intake of calcium. That's like the only mineral. The problem with osteoporosis, it's losing calcium. The body must expend calcium in order to try and get out these Frankenstein, diet Dr. Pepper, and all this trashy food that we're eating. Those processes use up calcium. That's what's making calcium leave the body.